Hello, Didier Stevens here, Senior Handler with Internet Storm Center. I'm going to show you the different indicators you can have with my OLEDump tool. So if you run OLEDump on an example with VBA code, like this, in this column here you can have indicators, and we are going to review the different indicators that you can see with OLEDump. So you have M. M indicates macro. Uppercase M means macros with actual code, so not only attributes, while lowercase m means only attributes. Let's look at the difference. So I select stream 7. Well, let's start with stream 8, lowercase m. And as you can see here, the VBA code is only attributes. While when I select stream 7, then I actually have some code. So that's the difference between lowercase m and uppercase m. By default, OLEDump will only show you the streams inside an OLE file. You can also see the storages. So storages are like folders. By using option storages. And then here you see the root entry, uppercase R. That's the storage, the root entry storage. And then you have the VBA project cure and the VBA storage. Those are both storages indicated with a dot. You can have an E indicator, uppercase E, tells you that it contains VBA code, but that there was an error when OLEDump tried to decompress it. So if I select stream 7 and decompress it, I get an error. You can still try to see the code, decompressed code, until the error happens by using option VBA decompress corrupt, because this is an indication of corruption. And then as you can see, you see VBA code until a certain point where the corruption happens. You can have embedded code inside a document, so an embedded file that is with indicator O for object. So if I select that object and ask for information, you can see here that it is a PE file, it is embedded inside that document. And then finally, here, exclamation mark. Again, this is VBA code, but VBA code that has been tampered with, stomped, for example. If you select stream 7, do decompression, you get error unable to decompress. So in this case, what you have to do is select the source code. So 7S, S stands for source code, and then decompress. And then you get an X ASCII dump of the decompressed code. And of course you can do a binary dump. And then you can see here the code. And we have that warning because this is not normal code. You have no attributes. I tampered with the attributes here. Another way to tamper would be to remove everything or put in random bytes. So these are the indicators that you can encounter with OLEDump. And I also have a blog post with an overview of the indicators. Here is the list.